Dear friends, in class 11 we are studying complex number and next point is power of I. Now we have already defined I is equal to root of minus 1. It means I square is equal to minus 1. Therefore I cube is equal to I square into I. Now I square is negative 1, it means this is equal to negative 1 into I. So it means this is equal to negative I. Now I raised to 4 is equal to, you can write I square, that is equal to minus 1 square. It means that is equal to minus 1 is equal, square of negative 1 is positive 1. Or it can be written as I square into I square is I raised to 4, that is equal to minus 1 into minus 1. It means it is positive 1. Now let's see what happens with the higher powers of I. For I raised to 5, we have I square into I square into I. Now I square, value of I square is negative 1, so we will get negative 1 multiplied by negative 1 multiplied by I. So this is I is equal to negative into negative is positive, 1 into 1 is 1. So here we get I. So please note, these values goes on repeating. If you take I raised to 6, it will be I square into I square into I square. So this is equal to minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1, that is equal to negative 1. Please note, values are repeating and this I is equal to root of minus 1. So you will notice the values goes on repeating, and for every I raised to 4, then I raised to 8, then I raised to 12, I raised to 16. Please note, these are multiples of 4. Powers are multiples of 4. You will notice the value is 1. So you can say, if I raised to power, where k is any integer, where k is any positive integer, you will notice that I is equal to always 1. Now, if you take I raised to 4k plus 1, means this is equal to, this will be always I, or it can be equal to I raised to 5, equals to I raised to 9, equals to I raised to 13, equals to I raised to 17. Please note, values goes on increasing. The difference is of 4, and the values are 4k multiplied 4k plus 1. So here you will notice the value is always I. For I raised to 4k plus 1, the value is always I. Then if you go for I raised to 4k plus 2, if the power is 4 into some integer plus 2, that is equal to I raised to 6, then I raised to 10, then it will be I raised to 14, I raised to 18, and so on. You will notice the value comes to minus 1. When you go for I raised to 4k plus 3, the value is negative I. So here you will notice it will be 4k plus 3. It means I raised to 7, that is equal to I raised to 11, that is also equal to I raised to 15, that is also equal to I raised to 19. You will notice the value comes to negative I, and value goes on repeating from of in these only, that is the value of the power of I will always be or will be in this, either it will be I, it will be negative I, or it will be positive 1 or negative 1. So that is all about power of I. Dear friends, now very interesting topic we are going to study. The square root of negative real numbers. Now try to understand. We have already defined I such that I square is equal to negative 1. Now see. So, if you take a square root of negative 1, it must be equal to I. And please note, don't get confused here. See here, square root of 9 is plus 3 and minus 3. Square root of 16 is plus 4 and negative 4. Square root of 4 is positive 2 and negative 2. This is what we have studied. So, square root of negative 1 must be positive I as well as negative I. This is what some people will feel. But in complex algebra, we are not going to consider the second. We are going to consider only this. It means root of negative 1 is always I and root of negative 1 is not equal to minus I. So don't get confused. We are going to consider this only. But if there is a quadratic equation x square plus 1 equals to 0. And if you try to solve this, you will get x square is equal to negative 1 by transposing 1 to the right hand side. By taking square root, you will get x is equal to plus or minus root of minus 1. It means x is equal to I as well as minus I. So in this case, both the roots exist for the quadratic equation x square plus 1 equals to 0. Dear friends, let us consider some other point, root 3 r. Root 3 r, I is outside the root, root is. If you square this, you will get root 3 square is 3, or you can say root 3 square into I square. So this is equal to root 3 square is 3, I square is negative 1, it means this is equal to negative 3. Now see what happens if the value is negative, if this is negative. Minus root 3 I bracket square. So this is equal to again negative root 3 square into I square. Negative into negative becomes positive and root 3 square is 3. So this becomes again 3 into minus 1. So this is also equal to negative 3. Please try to understand square of root 3 I is also same and square of negative root 3 I is also negative 3. Dear friends, we are going to consider next point, that is root a multiplied by root b. If a is greater than 0 and b is greater than 0, this is what we have already studied. Now root a into root b is equal to root of ab. That is, if you take the example root 3 multiplied by root 4, then this is equal to root 12. This is what we have already studied. Now see what happens if a is one of the number is less than 0, that is it is negative or it is equal to 0. If a equal to 0 and b is greater than 0, then we will see that we will get a root of 0 multiplied by 0 into root of 4. So this is equal to 0. It means LHS is equal to 0. So LHS equal to 0, RHS is equal to 0. So here root a into root b is equal to root AB holds. Now let us see what happens if one of the number, if B is equal to 0, we will again get the same. If A is less than 0 and B is greater than 0, what happens? Let us see. So let us take some example. If A is negative 3, that is less than 0, and B is greater than 0 multiplied by root 4, you will see that we will get root of negative 12. This is also true. But if both are less than 0, that is A is less than 0, B is less than 0, it means both the numbers are negative. If both the numbers are negative, let's see what happens. I will take root of minus 1 into root of minus 1. So, we will get root of minus 1 into root of minus 1 is equal to root of minus 1 multiplied by minus 1. Now this is equal to root of 1. Negative into negative becomes positive. 1 into 1 becomes 1. And this is equal to 1. Please note, we have already defined root of minus 1 is equal to I, and root of minus 1 square is equal to I square. Here we are getting 1. So please note that this is a wrong consideration. We cannot consider, or it is not true, that root A into root B is not equal to root of AB if A and B both are less than 0. So this is not a valid answer. This is a valid answer. So please note this point. If both the numbers are less than 0, then root A into root B is not equal to root of AB.